So a couple days ago, this lady emailed me saying that she is a producer of the Dr. Phil show. And she wanted to use my video, my TanaCon video that I made to air it on the show, wanted to know if they had my permission to air it. And she also asked if I wanted to share my experience and to give her a call to discuss more details. I'm scared.
Hey, how are you?
I'm good, how are you?
Good, thanks for giving me a call.
Yeah, no problem.
We're potentially like doing a show or like a story on TanaCon. My video team went on YouTube and they saw your video and then they were like, she's obviously beautiful and very well about TanaCon and has a personal experience to share. Everything just about it, they just like really like. I just wanted to see if potentially you would be interested in like give like a statement or potentially like call into the show. If you are interested, I would have to just arrange for like a quick call with someone on my team and just get a few notes from you. Awesome. Thank you so much.
All right. Have a good one.
All right. Happy
day. Okay. Bye. Bye. So, I'm going to be on the Dr. Phil show. This is fucking weird, dude. Hello?
Hi, Alyssa. This is from Dr. Phil. How are you?
Hi, I'm good. How are you?
I'm pretty well. Not much. We are just kind of following up and confirming that people are still expect to be with today regarding this TanaCon episode. Would you still be joining us today?
Yes, I will.
Perfect.
So I just got off the phone with one of the executive producers, I believe, at the Dr. Phil show, and they're going to be emailing me a link to virtually attend the audience of a taping of the Dr. Phil show about TanaCon. First of all, how crazy. Second of all, TanaCon happened like 2 years ago, so I'm a little bit confused as to why, you know, this is still like relevant. Is Tana going to be on the show? Am I going to have a moment? Am I just going to sit in the audience? I have no idea. Potentially nothing could happen and I could just, you know, be in the audience and observe what's happening. But I think that this experience is way too like weird and crazy to not document. So here we go. That's what today's video is. I don't know what's going on. Long time no see. What's up? How's it hanging? So it's been 7 months since I last filmed anything for this video. I was told that this episode was supposed to air in November of 2020 and it is now May 2021. So it's been a long time. I was starting to think that this episode was never going to air and that I was never going to be able to share my crazy experience with everything that happened on the taping of that show. But now that the episodes have aired and everything is out there for you to see, I can finally talk about it and I have a lot to say. So I don't think I need to explain TanaCon to anybody, but it was 3 years ago, so here's a quick reminder. Tana Mojo was angry at VidCon for not making her a featured creator and treating her very badly, so she planned a dumpster fire of a convention within a month that promised fans to meet their favorite creators for free. And we all remember how that went. Two years later, I was emailed by a producer at the Dr. Phil show that asked me if they could use my video that I made, my experience at TanaCon, for the show and if I wanted to join the live audience. Obviously, I said yes, but I had no idea. Like, they told me nothing about the episode. They just said it was about TanaCon. So I went into it thinking maybe Tana's gonna be there. Like, I don't know what angle they're gonna approach, who's gonna be on the show. Like, is there gonna be drama? Is there gonna be fights? Like, what's gonna happen? I questioned a lot of things, particularly the relevance of it all, the relevancy, because TanaCon was 3 years ago now, 2 years ago then when I got that email. And so it just seems so random. Like, what's the point? What's going on? What's new? But when I showed up for the taping of the show, it all became clear that it was about Michael Weiss, the organizer of the event, you know, this guy. Yeah, apparently he hasn't been doing so well. Surprise, surprise. He's gone bankrupt. He's getting death threats to this day and backlash, and he wanted to go on the show to clear his name. That's what he said his whole purpose was for doing the show. But
ironically, it ended up doing the exact opposite. In fact, I think it made things a lot worse for him, but I'm getting ahead of myself. So I just wanted to come on here, react to some clips from the show, summarize the drama with Michael. They actually did end up using a little segment of my video for like the teaser of like what's to come later in the episode. So that was pretty cool to see. Honestly, there was so much drama in this episode. Like while I was actually watching the live taping of it, I was shocked at how many things were said and like alleged that he had done. I guess for like every episode of Dr. Phil, he has like a team of people that investigate the person that they're doing the episode on. So like they asked for like stories about Michael from ex-employees, ex-friends, ex-business partners, and they dug up so much dirt on him. Like I was just flabbergasted. I was in shock because a lot of these allegations were pretty serious and it just really painted him in a bad light. I won't say anything else. Let's get into it. So I want to start by watching the little segment they used from my video because it's so funny the way that they edited it. They made it so dramatic and I get it. It's for TV. Like it has to be dramatic. They have to play it up, but it just looks and sounds so funny. Just watch.
TanaCon got canceled. This weekend was promised to be filled with the possibility to meet all my favorite creators for free or for the small price of $65. Let me tell you what $65 got me. It got me a disgusting sunburn on my shoulder, chest, and scalp. I got a really bad sunburn for waiting in line for 4 hours for literally nothing.
It's too funny. My sunburn. I totally forgot I had that nasty sunburn. I was wearing like an off the shoulder type shirt, so I had these really like awkward sunburns on my shoulders and on my chest and on my scalp. No, had no idea that you could even get your scalp sunburned, but so many people were so quick to tell me,
oh, obviously you can get your scalp sunburned. It's a part of your body. It's a skin on your body.
Like, oh my god. Excuse me. Sorry, I didn't know that. Okay, damn. That was one of my most viewed videos. I think to this day, it's one of my most popular videos. And I had so many people coming from left and right to nitpick all the little things I said. It was too much fame for me. I couldn't handle it. But that brings back a lot of traumatic memories. I'm gonna skip that. Honestly, I don't even know if that was it. I didn't watch the like live version on TV. I watched just like, you know, the segment on YouTube. So I don't even know if there was a little bit more that they used for my video, but I did show up a few times in the second episode, like in the back screen. I was in the virtual audience and I kept referencing like that one SpongeBob episode where he was in that Krusty Krab commercial.
Food in the seven seas.
There I am, Gary, there I am.
I was watching it with my family. So every time I would see my face on the screen for like 2 seconds, I'm like, look, Gary, there I am. It was so funny. Good times. But speaking of good times, what a nice segue, right? Okay. I know a lot of people go on Dr. Phil claiming that they have negative experiences because of the editing. Like they edit them to look like this super horrible, evil person. But I was there. I watched them do the show. I watched both episodes already and there was no editing done that could make Michael look worse than he already did. He was really a character. He was really something else on that episode. I don't know if he was playing it up for the cameras, but I don't know why he would do that. They had Amanda from Swell Entertainment call in to share her experience with TanaCon. She's a well-known YouTuber who went to the event and she called in. She was like holding him accountable for so many lies that he was telling. So many things that I completely forgot that happened. She was like pulling out the receipts for and I was like, okay, girl, go off. Like if they had asked me to do that, I would have choked because this happened so long ago. That's out of my memory. She popped off. She really was hitting him with the facts. And of course, he was being so rude and dismissive, unapologetic. He didn't care for anything that she said. And he was being so freaking catty, dude. Like, he was not having it. And there was one point where he was just playing the victim card so hard and saying, I'm receiving all these death threats and people are telling me that I should kill myself. And he was like, do you think I should kill myself?
Something I've dealt with for 3 years. Every waking moment told that I'm a worthless human being over a mistake and that I should kill myself? Are you kidding me?
You shouldn't kill yourself.
What'd you say? I should?
I was in the audience like, my virtual screen. I was like, Girl, he was a whole mess. Despite him being a terrible person and completely unprofessional, obviously he doesn't deserve to get death threats. Do not ever send anyone these nasty messages telling them to, you know, themselves, because that's not okay. Don't do that. It's not funny. It's not cool. Like, I want to feel bad for him, and I do feel bad for him that he's receiving death threats, because he shouldn't be in the first place, but it's really hard to, like, feel for him when he's being so dismissive of any criticism that came his way. Later on in the episode, two of his ex-employees came on the show, one of which was the girl that announced that TanaCon was canceled at the event. Her name is Sydney Monroe, and I feel so incredibly bad for her. Sydney, you're a real one. She did not deserve anything that came her way. She was basically handed a microphone and told to go outside and announce to a mob of angry, hungry, sunburned people that the event that they had waited in line for hours for was canceled. Like, I still remember watching her get up on that plastic raggedy ass table and shout in the megaphone saying that it's canceled, and immediately I knew that, like, all hell was about to break loose. Like, I felt so scared for her. I thought she was gonna get beat up, dude, because they were yelling at her, throwing water bottles at her, the angry moms were hitting her legs, she got her phone stolen. I was watching the Cheers Brother podcast with Caitlin and Sarah, and she said that she had to go to therapy because of what she experienced. Like, that was that traumatic for her. And I completely understand. I get it. And, like, she did not deserve that. Like, I feel so bad for her. But I'm glad that she's, you know, okay, and, like, she got help for that, because I would literally be traumatized from that too. People were so horrible. And the moms that were hitting her, dude, like, really? You have nothing better to do? You, like, oh my god. I can't with people. Shame on you. But after all of that, they went on to explain how horrible of a boss Michael was, how unprofessional he was, how there was multiple occasions where he would make his employees cry. There was an event where his employees were told that they had to earn a bed to sleep in. He apparently threw water bottles at them. Like, this guy has a serious ego problem. There's a lot wrong with him, but let me carry on, because I can go on about that. And get this, later on in the show, his director of operations, or ex-director of operations for one of his old companies, and former roommate came on the show to say that she was physically and verbally abused by him. And he, of course, he had an excuse for all of it. So I'm finding it really hard to feel sorry for him, and I just don't. But the one takeaway that I got from this, and hopefully that you get from this, is that Michael is not professional at all. He's a terrible friend. He's very manipulative and insecure, and he definitely has a lot of work to do on himself. But obviously that's not gonna happen in one Dr. Phil episode. But that's the basic rundown of what happened on the show. If you wanna watch it, you totally can. They have the episodes on Dr. Phil's YouTube channel, but, you know, you're not missing much. It was very dramatic, and it was entertaining, not gonna lie. Overall, it was a fun experience. It was very random to be hit up by a producer of the Dr. Phil show, but thank you for getting in contact with me. It was fun to see part of my video aired on a Dr. Phil show. And it was just fun to see the live taping of something go down like that. But that's all I have for you guys today. Thank you so much for watching. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments down below. As always, I love you guys very much, and I will see you in the next one. Bye. Perfect.